We solemnly swear we're up to no good.
Hi, I'm Gary Roby.
I'm Victoria Laguna.
And we're the hosts of Harry Potter Minute, the fan podcast where we overanalyze the Harry Potter movies one magical minute at a time.
Join us as we argue about whether or not McGonagall would meow at Dumbledore.
She wouldn't. As we ponder just how much Harry's fortune is worth.
Just $40. As we guess how much mileage one gets out of an Ollivander wand.
100,000 jinxes. As we detail the ins and outs of Hogwarts Castle.
It's only a model.
Join us Monday through Friday, only from DuelingGenre.com.
Mischief managed.
Dueling Genre.
Welcome back to Rocky Minute, the daily podcast where we analyze the movie Rocky 1 minute at a time. I'm Doug Greenberg.
And I'm Jason Haynes.
And who's joining us this week?
Oh, that would be Matt
Marchand.
No?
Marchand.
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 You gotta roll the R.
not like a like a Spanish.
No.
You gotta do it from like the back of your throat, right, Matt, if I'm not mistaken? It's like
Marchand.
Today, we're knocking out minute 79, which begins with a horny Adrian, and it ends with a Rocky apology.
Mm-hmm. Doug's gonna have to explain to your kids what horny is later.
they're on their iPads, they're good. So Adrian's trying to get some.
Oh, is she ever. Dirty little Adrian. This is years of oppressed virginity that's just pouring out now. She just wants it.
Well, The line in the script when they first kissed was the dam of passion erupting. So once you knock down that dam of passion, man.
Speaking of rolling your R's. Dam of passion erupting?
So she tries kissing him, but he's not having it. He tells her no fooling around.
No fooling around during training.
But she's not taking no for an answer. She keeps going in for it.
Right.
And I'm wondering, how does it feel, Rocky? How does it feel to be persistent and pushy when the person is trying to decline your advances?
I don't know how he can possibly turn her down in that pink house coat. I mean, it's hard to. It's a Victoria's Secret bestseller there.
Damn, the Adrian house coat.
Yeah, it's from the Old Maiden collection. Yeah, we'll do a fake Victoria's Secret ad.
Doesn't this lamp in the right hand side look like a the thing? What is it? I don't know the things they smoke the hookah out of in like the hookah bars, but all the pipes that come off of it or whatever.
Is that what you smoke out of it? Hookah?
No. Oh,
you know, chiza or something like that.
The hookah is the like a hookah bar. What's this thing called?
I don't know.
Not this lamp, but
this thing. What's it? Do you smoke? It's tobacco, right?
Yeah, like you go to a hookah bar.
Flavored tobacco, right? Like shisha or something. It's called shisha or something like that.
Well, I'll Google it while you guys talk about other things.
I don't make my way to many hookah bars, so I don't know. But she realizes that Rocky's not playing a sexy, hard-to-get game, which clearly turns her on. But she just kind of lays on him sweetly, and she asks if he's sure.
Oh, the hookah is the thing you smoke the stuff out of. It's like a hookah bar is full of hookahs. It's a single or multi-stem instrument for vaporizing and smoking flavored tobacco called muasa, or sometimes cannabis. Mm.
Yes, that thing right there does look like the...
It looks like the lamp in the scene. So go ahead. It has nothing to do with rocks.
You've been smoking too much of that bong.
That's why Adrian's so turned on.
But he tells her, just make the meat.
Mmm. Dirty talk.
But, I mean, poor Adrian. Poor Adrian. You tell her no, and then you give her, like, a menial task to do.
Yeah.
That was a little kick in the gut right there.
But he regretted it immediately. He has a look in his eye, like, either he was, like, upset about what he just said, and, like, he's kind of giving her a look like... He feels bad. He's looking at her like, oh, I shouldn't have said that or whatever. Or he's looking at her like, man, I made a big mistake coming onto this girl and now I can't get rid of her. how many times when you're growing up did you like, you want a girl, you put all your effort into it, then you finally get her and you're like, oh, this isn't what I thought it was going to be.
Not all it's cracked up to be.
I don't want to mention names in case she's listening.
Back to the pet shop for you.
But you see, like, she takes the meat. She goes, fine, I'll make the meat. And she leaves. And there's like a 10, 11 second zoom on his face as he realized he done fucked up. It's now, why does he push her away?
It's like Batman walking through with the house with his cape on.
that's a precursor look to like maybe what we could have seen if Sly was Superman.
Man, imagine that.
Ooh.
Wow.
Now, does he push her away because it's a training thing, you know, women weak in legs, no booty while training, or is it the gravity of everything is weighing on him?
Gravity. He's got a lot going on suddenly.
Like, he's stressed out over this one fight, right? This one fight that's going to be, you know, however long a 15-round fight takes, 15 rounds by three. So a 45-minute fight. Is that 15 times three? Sure is. A 45-minute fight that he's training for, but Adrian is forever.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like he's stressing out over this fight, and, you know, the one thing he should be focusing on is the woman that he loves. So you do see regret. You see remorse for the way he just talked to her. If you notice, I mean, he gets up and he goes over to the kitchen, you know, to apologize, but we never see Rocky treat Adrian like this again.
Yeah.
Throughout all the movies. Mm-hmm. It was like this one moment of regret was all it took, and we never see that again. Do Rocky and Adrian close the deal right now?
What? What's the deal?
Like, do they get it on?
I would think so.
I don't think so. I think no. She goes and makes the meat.
Yeah?
Yeah. Can we talk about what the hell this picture hanging on the wall is in the dining room? It's
my lord, what is that?
I have no idea. It's like a redheaded. It first of all, it doesn't match anything else in the apartment. The apartment is all like old timey. Well, not old time back then. It's old time now. But it's like the wood paneling, the ugly dining room chairs, the lamp, the old phone. Like everything's old. And then there's just this weird picture of like a redheaded drawing of a sadistic looking woman with a possibly this blue. Is this like a ghost behind her?
I don't know, but the woman herself in the painting looks like a demon of some sort.
Yeah, it's like a weird. I don't know, man.
Wow,
it doesn't match anything in the room.
Oh, that's bizarre,
right?
I mean, if you showed me,
you think anyone's got like pieces of that room? Like, I mean, like the stuff that was in that room. Do you think people out there have things from it?
Like the doily on the armrest of the couch or the hookah lamp? Maybe.
Yeah. Rocky's, like when I saw Rocky on the big screen for the 40th, for the first time ever, when Mickey goes to Rocky's apartment, I noticed that there's a bucket of KFC on the table.
Yeah.
I never noticed that before.
Well, here there's like a little carton of milk or half and half next to the coffee mug on the table. Like, how long has that been sitting out? Is it morning? What time of day is it right now?
What do they do after a movie? Do they, like, auction off the set pieces and stuff, or they just throw them in a warehouse somewhere?
They probably reuse them.
Or maybe that was
warehouse in Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
I like that phone. I've seen that phone in other films before.
They repurpose it? Or is it just something that was in the house where they filmed? Because I don't think this was a set, right? This was the inside of the real house.
Yeah.
So it's just a painting that was hanging on the wall?
Could be.
And it kept, yeah.
It doesn't fit the house, though. Where's your dog licking my crotch?
They had a really small budget for clothes, so I would have to
assume it was
the people's houses.
Yeah, I would think so. So when they wrap filming, they start taking the paintings off the wall, and people are like, wait, that's mine. Oh, man.
Is this a turtle?
He brought Cuff and Link over for a visit. So Jay, you don't think that they make sweet love?
No.
And Matt, you do think they make sweet love?
I think, you know, possibly, you know. I don't know. I think Adrian is would respect Rocky's wishes not to.
I do think so.
I agree, but right now, if...
Their love is so young still, in the sense that they've only been together for a couple of days, that maybe that passion would overtake them, but...
Yeah.
I don't know. Hard to say.
Hmm.
You know, because Rocky gives in, then She's going to have to train him and not Mickey, right?
Yeah, if only they cut to a shot of him maybe smoking, walking down the street smoking, we might have a better idea, because that's the typical post-sex thing to do is smoke. And but now they cut to... Oh, it's not even this. Nope, not this minute. So I'll have to stop right there.
Yeah. Go no further.
Yeah, I mean, this was a pretty light minute because about one-fifth of that was that zoom in on Rocky's face, so not much else going on.
That was a whole minute?
Let's see. It started with a horny Adrian, and it ended with a Rocky apology. Did I mention that he apologized? He goes over to the kitchen, apologizes,
yeah.
And Adrian like kind of comes out and hugs him. So look at that, fight over. If only every husband and wife fight went that quickly and smoothly.
Ended that quickly, right?
Yeah.
That's how they end in the beginning.
And like they're that steak looks pretty small. Do you think like he was going to eat all that to himself? He didn't even bring her in steak for breakfast?
No, she was cooking that for him. Just make the steak. He needs his protein. He's training.
It's like, yo, Adrian, there's some eggs in the fridge. Knock yourself out.
There's some old cream on the...
have an omelet.
I like them raw myself.
All right. I mean, I'm... Like I said, I got nothing else for this minute, so...
All right. Me either.
I'm ready to wrap it up.
Yeah.
I mean, you pretty much covered everything that Rambo Mania has... And Stallone Fanatics. Anything else you're working on? You're a part of? You have Twitter handles or websites you want to plug?
I can't follow all on Twitter. I can't figure out how that thing works. Hello? All
right.
Just, you know, Rambo Mania on Steel Red Band on YouTube and the new one coming out probably on archive.org. And Stallone Fanatics on CastBox. And we were actually talking last night about maybe doing a review of Capone.
Oh, yeah.
Because I don't think anyone ever reviewed that. And I haven't seen it yet, so.
When, that was early, right? Was that, when did that come out?
I don't even know. That would have to say 70s sometime.
Yeah, it was before Rocky, I want to say. Or was it in between Rocky and Rocky 2? I don't know.
Don't even know.
If only there was a magic machine we can look up information like this on.
Yeah.
Let's see. IMDb.com. Capone.
What are we
up? Sylvester Stallone's.
I haven't been paying attention.
1975. So there you go.
Wow.
75. So you guys
are. I can't wait to see that.
Are after 42, 43 years, you're going to do a review of Capone. Nice.
Yeah. I can't believe I've never seen it. And I've never seen anyone else review it. So I was like, wow, we should do that, you know?
And
Chris loves that movie. He actually picked it up last night, too, again. So
a rare role for Stallone where he plays a gangster.
Yeah. I hear it's not no Snaps Provolone. A little darker.
Snaps Provolone. Oh man, right. Well, if you went, I'm learning the Twitter machine myself, so I know a little bit, slightly more than fuck all about it.
Yeah,
we're Rocky Minute there. We have a Facebook listeners page. It's a closed group. It's called Mighty Mix. You put in a request and you'll get added right away. A lot of these shows have closed groups, not invitation only, but the request to keep spam bots and whatnot out. So, I know slightly more than fuck all about Facebook too. So I just followed the,
Facebook seems to be my thing. I just finally got on Instagram. I had an old account from a couple of years ago, but I only used it one time. So now I'm finally on Instagram officially. Hopefully I can figure that out a little better.
Yeah, Instagram, I'm, haven't really been on it in a long time, but it's that one kind of skipped me by. Maybe I should pick it up. Maybe we should start a Rocky Minute page on Instagram. Share all the cool photos that Chris has been putting on Stallone Fanatics.
Well, Chris, me and Chris are going to be throwing some new stuff out there because we're planning on sneaking around the Creed 2 set.
Oh, wow.
Trip in there. Yeah.
Wow, that'll be cool.
You guys should come with us, man. You're only like 2 hours away.
Not even. Like an hour or an hour outside of Philly?
Yeah.
Dude, that would be awesome. Feel like going to visit the Creed set?
Yeah, when?
Now?
Yeah, probably February.
Yeah, I'm free in February.
Yeah, Valentine's Day somewhere.
If you and Chris are coming out, yeah, absolutely. 100%, we're down.
Yeah, we can do a Honda in there. And
yeah, we'll do like a special Rocky Minute hiatus episode.
Yeah, maybe Jeff Hewitt and Jeff
Ferry.
The other Jeff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Sly Chaos guys.
Jeff Ferry.
We got, so far we've had Craig on, we've had Mike on, and we got the two Jeffs scheduled. So we are going to complete the Sly Cast collection by the end of this show. So
that's awesome. Going to be amazing. Yeah. Are you guys going to do like Rocky 2 and then Rocky 3?
If there's a demand for it, that's our plan. But if nobody's listening, we might not. But no, that is our hope. We want to continue even with the Creeds too. If you know, like I said, if people are listening, we definitely like to pump out more of these. It is very time consuming, as our wives can attest.
Yeah, I get that all the time. All the time. I'll but definitely be listening.
All right, at least we got one.
As far as you guys want to go, I'll be there.
That's perfect. Right. Yeah, stop by the Mighty Mix listeners page, everybody, and let us know if you want us to continue. But until tomorrow, when we're covering minute 80, oh, it's the end of the week already? Went by so quick, didn't it? All right.
We got one more day. For another week.
I appreciate that. All right. So tomorrow we'll pick up with minute 80. We'll talk to you all on the next Rocky Minute.